Hello, Michelle.
Hello, Anne-Chloé.
What can I do for you today?
Anne-Chloé, I want to say, so before making the call, I wanted to say that I want to just go wherever it goes. And then about 15 minutes ago, I wanted to say something different, and I'm going to go there and then we'll see.
Mm-hmm.
I've been space holding and going on linear and having very in tune with my energy body and really powerful space holding for new people that mm-hmm. actually have no experience, and people are going liquid, and that brings me a lot of joy. And when I'm in those spaces, I'm in my energy, I'm in my game world, I'm a healer, and I feel strong.
Yeah.
And I have a purpose, and I'm in my, yeah, I'm in archetypal love a lot in those spaces. Then on my day to day, there's this fear that gets intertwined, kind of the feeling of fear. I'm very connected to my feelings, and that brings me joy. And I work on being aware of my feelings. And with fear, it gets intertwined with emotion. So the feeling of fear, it gets intertwined with emotion. And then I feel it now in my body. It becomes this running battery. And my fear about that fear is that it depletes my energy, mm-hmm. and my energy needed for my work. And I've worked with, I went liquid state with fear during a lab, and I've been working on that and consciously practicing slowing down. The behavior looks like this. I'll speak fast. I'll do things quickly.
Mm-hmm.
I have a big energy about me, and for the most part, people feel safe around me, I've heard. And there are others that find my energy too big and feel, I want to say, smothered by it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want that. I want connection. I don't want to have that effect that happens at times.
Yeah, Michelle, I want to, because we've also, you know, met each other along the years, and I mean, in my experience is when I do my work, I'm, you know, I had this idea, God, I want to do it and people can receive it. And the more I grow and the more I, you know, in your experience, like get into archetypal love and be in those spaces. And I got to a point where I have a sense now that probably half of the people will love my work and love my presence and my energy, and half of the people won't. And yeah. In this, when you were saying, you know, I want connection, I don't want people to be scared by me, it sensed that then there's a compromise, that you would compromise yourself.
Thank you for that. And the sadness I feel at times about that is that it seems to be in impossibility management spaces that can happen. And like I say, it's not often, it's not frequent, and it still happens. And so I yes to what you're saying. And I've really, I've come to the realization that that is true. Not everybody is going to resonate or like. And then I have a respect for possibility management, so that then I have fear, am I not doing things correct? You know, it's this little,
yeah, I'm not wrong. Doing things right. Yeah.
Yeah. So that happens too. And thank you for that as well.
Michelle, I would go with this underlying emotional fear, which, you know, in modern culture, they would call anxiety living with stress. And you've said it, it's this emotional fear that is constantly running.
Yeah, like a motor.
Yeah, like a motor, and it exhausts the nervous system. It's exhausting for the nervous system.
It is. I'd like to share one more thing just as an evidence that it's a motor that I really want to work with, is that I ran an experiment last weekend. I was driving back on Monday. This is why I was in a car. The experiment went like this. I spent 3 days on my own, drove 4 hours to a place and went on boat rides for 2 days with strangers and chose not to interact at all. So just my being with their beings and seeing if my archetypal love, like who is Michelle if she's not being friendly and helping others and being conscious of their needs, right? And the boat ride was super rough. It was a perfect experiment, by the way, in the sense of the roughness of the ocean. So I was able to just be grounded and look at the flying fish where everyone else was screaming and yelling. So it was actually easier than I thought. It was a beautiful experiment. And I left there feeling great. And then of course the call on Monday had everything to do with a new action. Mm-hmm. And I just done it. I felt so glad about Echo. Echo's a constant with me. I'm very grateful about that. 2 days later, I felt the motor running again. Mm. And I'm so angry about this. Like this feeling of, it doesn't matter how much I do, this motor's running. So thank you. I wanted to share I'm running experiments around it, Anne-Chloé, and they don't seem to work.
Well, I would disagree with that. I think, like you said, it was a really useful and powerful experiment. And it's about building matrix to get to know, as you say, who am I? Who am I when I don't have this constant fear of rescuing people and helping people and being friendly, which is run by fear. And Correct. You can do as many experiments to build matrix, but you need to address the emotion. Like, what is this really about? When did you decide that that was a worthy survival strategy?
Yes.
So yeah. if you close your eyes and try to not blow it out your lips. Yeah, just close your eyes. Don't blow it out your lips and just let it get bigger. Okay, but there's no hurry. So just let the sensation, this motor. Michelle, can I ask you a question before you do this? I noticed that you cannot keep your eyes closed for more than about 3 seconds. Did you know that about yourself?
Was there a question?
Yeah, did you notice that about yourself before, that you couldn't keep your eyes closed for more than about 3 or 4 seconds?
Yes, I do it unconsciously. So thank you for pointing it out.
Yeah, it's not bad, but it's okay. What is that about? So if you try to close your eyes, and instead of opening your eyes, let the feeling get bigger. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So I feel sadness, and I'm going to unmix the sadness because it's taking over.
Can you say what the sadness is about before you put it on the side?
Thank you. The sadness is about, I don't want this fear anymore. Mm. I'm sad about that. I want my energy in for what I'm here to do. I feel sad about that.
You feel sad about this energy that keep using energy instead of using it for your work. Yeah.
Yes. I feel sad because I've been given such gifts and and this is taking a toll.
Yeah. Just let the sadness be there. Don't try to get rid of it just yet. Yeah. 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 Just sadness. Yeah, just sadness. When the fear comes in, just let the fear get big. Yeah. Oh. Yes.
Oh.
Oh. Yes. Yeah, and there's a scream. There's more than one scream, actually. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yes, and the scream is high pitched. Yes. Yeah. You're still holding back to the scream. You're still holding it back. Yet. Yes. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Let it big, big, big. It's huge. It is huge. This fear. It is huge. Yes. 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 Yes, that's it. Yes. Yes. Yes, Michelle. Yes. Keep going. Keep going. You've been inside of you for so long. Yes. Yes. Yes, 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 Michelle, yes. Yes, keep going. Yes. Just fear, yes. Yes. I'm going to ask your bodies. Yes. Don't try to get rid of it yet. Don't try to make it go away. Yes. It is inside of you. It is inside of you. Yes. Yes. Michelle, I'm gonna ask your body's questions. Is it nighttime or daytime?
Nighttime.
Thank you. Are you laying, standing, or sitting? Or sitting? Yes. Are you in a place you know, a place you don't know?
It's so dark. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, it's dark. Yeah. Yes. Are you alone or with somebody?
Hello.
Thank you. Michelle, how old are you? Trust your body. How old are you? Yes.
Like 13. No, younger.
I think it's way before that. Way before that.
No. Like 4. It's little, and then it's
go back to the first time. It happened more than once. It seems like it happened more than once. What was the time before three?
Like before one, I don't know, baby.
Yes.
I don't know.
Yes. I think you were a few months old.
It's a cave. I'm in a cave. Like, what is this? It's so... it's so dark and it's cold. I'm so cold. It's so cold here.
It's so dark and it's so cold, and you're this really small baby, few months old. Michelle, I know that you've had past life where you might have had some similar fears. We're staying in this life. We're staying in this life. You were a small, small baby, and you had this, it was at night, it was so dark, you're laying. You're probably in a like a baby bed, a cradle.
Okay.
Yes, stay with the feeling, stay with that fear. Yes. Yes. What is happening? Yes, what is so terrifying?
It's just no one around.
Yes.
There's no one. There's nobody around. Where is there?
Yes, there's nobody around. What is it like? What is it like?
It's so scary. There's no one around.
Yes, the sun is out. Where is your mom?
She's not around. She's just not around.
And your father?
Oh, no, he's not around.
Yes. Yes, let those sounds out, Michelle. Don't. It's in, those screams are inside of you. Yes. Yes. What are you trying to say? You know, a baby cannot speak. What are you trying to say?
Come back.
Yes.
Come back. I'll be quiet.
Who are you talking to in particular?
My mom.
Yeah. Come back, mom.
I can't breathe, mom. Come back.
Yes. Yes, let the coughing, yes. Yes.
Oh, I can't breathe.
Yes. It's so huge, Michelle. It's so big. Yes.
Help me.
Yes. Yes. When this was happening, Michelle, when you were 5 months old and this, and it was nighttime, you were alone and you could not breathe and you were screaming, but you were still alone. There's nobody around. What did you decide?
There's no one there. There's no one. I'm alone. I'm alone.
I'm alone. Yes.
She doesn't care.
Yes. Misha, what did you decide about being wanted? Yes. Can you feel that even in your smallest body, you really screamed for a very long time? You kept going. You kept going, yes. Yes.
My throat.
Your throat was closing?
Yes. There's something. My throat was closing. Right.
And then,
I'm so scared.
Michelle, did that ever happen afterwards that you had your throat closed like that?
Yes, I did.
It
like
happened.
The group. Yes, like the group, like closed like that. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, several times after too.
Yeah. Yes. What was happening in your body? What was happening in your body that your throat would close? It happened after. What is your body trying to say?
It's not safe there. It's not safe.
And therefore, it's not safe, therefore?
To be myself.
Yeah. And therefore, it's not safe. How are you gonna make it safe? How did you make it safe?
Oh, I just was so, just happy all the time.
Yeah.
Making sure everyone's okay. All the time.
Yeah. Therefore, I decide to be happy and make other people happy all the time. What happens if you don't?
They'll be alone again.
Yeah, and your throat will close again. You might die.
I might die.
Yes.
Oh. Oh.
There's more fear. Yes.
She took me to the bathroom with hot water. Yeah.
She finally came. Your mother finally came.
Another time. Yeah, older.
Who came?
Mom. She was so scared because I couldn't breathe.
But that was another time. It was another time. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. We went in the shower with hot water. She was so scared. And I couldn't. Oh my gosh, she was so scared.
Yeah.
Ay, pobrecita.
Yeah, every time you had this, it's a form of a panic attack. You, this like throat closing, this is like so intense fear, that your throat would close. Every time it was a memory of this being a baby. Being a baby, screaming and being alone and being so terrified of being alone.
Terrified.
Yeah. Yes. And that is what's been running. This emotional fear that's been running in you like a motor is this fear that was in your body since you were a few months old. When the next wave comes, just take the next wave.
Yeah.
Yes, I want to tell you one thing is, there's a way that when the fear is locked in the body is a way that we freeze. It like when the fear is locked, it freezes us. It's sort of like a statue. It freezes us into a statue. And when you're expressing this fear, it is a way to melt this freeze. Can you feel it? Yeah. So when you do the next wave of fear, keep melting it. Keep melting the freeze. Yes. This is conscious fear. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ooh. Blah, blah,
yes.
Blah, 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 blah.
Yes. And let it be big. Yes.
Ooh. Oh,
yes. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Yes, keep melting the freeze. Yes. Yes. It's probably around your throat. A lot of that fear is around your throat. Yes.
In here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And when you make a big scream, let it come from here. Let it come from there. Let it come from the shoulder and the neck. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Oh. And the scream. Yes. Yes, it's been locked in there, Michelle. Yes. Let Michelle, let the fear move in your body. It was frozen there. It was frozen on your shoulders. And now you can just, and let it, when you feel it, let it circulate as an energy. Yes.
Oh.
Yes. Thank you. Yeah, I can see you. I can see you good. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Just pure fear. Put the sadness on the side. Pure fear, high pitch. And let it melt. Yes. Yes.
Oh.
Yes, let it circulate in your body. Yes, in your nervous system. Yes. 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 Yes, yes. Yes, yes, let it move through, let it move through, yes. Yes. And Michelle. Come all the way down to zero now. Come all the way down to zero. Yeah. Let the fear keep, let it circulate. And there's another, and if there's another feeling, just go into that pure feeling. There's a way, Michelle, when you tense like this, when you go, oh, is that you're not allowing the feelings, whatever feelings, to flow. Try to not tense and just trust your body. You have trained yourself to experience those feelings. Yes. It doesn't mean numbing, it's just mean the next wave. Yes, yes, yes. What which feeling is that, Michelle?
It's the fear.
Okay, then you take the next wave. Next wave is a fear.
Wow.
Don't try to block it. You're very good at blocking it. Ugh. Just let it get big. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Let it melt Yes, when the wave come, don't tense. Let it flow. And there might be a big scream that comes. Yes, don't block that. Don't block it. Just let the scream out. Yes. Let the sound out. Yes. Yes. And let it circulate. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, big scream. Yes, yes, yes. This is it, Michelle. This is it. That's the scream. Yes. 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 Let it keep coming. Yes. Just pure fear. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, let it move in your body. Let it move in your body. Yes. Michelle, yes. When you go big, then go down. Go, do this practice. Go big and then come to zero and take the wave. Yes. Yes. All the way big, all the way big. And then all the way down to zero. Let your body integrate it. Let it move. Let it move. This is a practice, Michelle, because you have your bodies. I used to be alive with about 20 to 30% ongoing fear all the time. And so there's a way that you don't experience yet what it's like when it's zero fear. And so that's the practice of you. It's like inhaling and exhaling. You know, if you inhale, you also need to exhale all the way before you can take a next exhale. So going back down to zero is like an exhale. It's not about becoming numb. It's about giving the range to your body between 0 and 100% fear. Yeah, all the way down. Yeah. Ugh. Can you feel the difference between this and numbness? That yes. From there, you can move anywhere. You can take the next wave, even the most subtle one.
Yes.
But when you run that like 30% intense fear all the time, you're missing the subtle fears, you know, between 0 and 30, and your nervous system just gets so exhausted. It's like this complete motor. Yeah.
Feel sad about that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
What is the next feeling? There was sadness, and then?
It felt like a lot of sadness and a little fear, really. A lot of sadness,
right? Okay.
Yeah.
You did super, Michelle. Like, this fear was like locked in your body for decades. It was just locked in there.
Thank you.
It's huge to be a baby like that and to be left alone and to scream and to scream and nobody comes. It's huge. Try to next, you know, this was a wave of sadness and now it's coming down back to zero, closer to zero. And then what's the next wave? Anger, fear, joy, or sadness again. Yeah, which feeling is that?
Fear, it's fear, it's fear, it's fear again.
Okay. Fear. Yeah. Take the wave, just take the wave.
I see.
Yeah, don't block it. Let it flow. Let it flow. You've been really good at blocking it for all these years. But don't But let the experience and the sound.
Yeah. Ay, 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 ay. Ay, ay, ay,
ay. Yes, and the sound. Yes, yes, yes. 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 You're doing great. Yes, keep melting. Yes, all the way down your spine. Yes. All the way big, all the way big, and then come down. Yes. 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 And then let it integrate. This is really precise inner navigation. Conscious inner navigation. Go all the way big, fear, and then come down. Exhale. It doesn't take very long for the next wave, whatever feeling it is, to come.
Oh, it's fear again.
Okay. What's the fear about, Michelle? What's the fear about this time? Oh, What's the fear about? What is the information of that fear? Say, I feel scared because or about?
I'm scared because it's everywhere. This thing is everywhere.
What is this thing? What is the thing?
This collective fear is it's everywhere.
This fear about what?
Fear of alone.
Being alone, this fear of being alone?
Yes, being alone. Yes. So many, it's just close. So long. It's so long. It's everywhere. It's like a tar, like a glue on me, like a tar. Like tentacles, like a big blob of alone, yeah, chip, 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 so many. Recitos, recitos.
Yeah. Receptors. just fear, Michelle. And just come all the way down to zero. I want to tell you there's a distinction. There's a distinction from being a vessel of collective pain, collective fear. This is one thing. And feeling other people's emotion. These are two different things. And feeling other people's emotion often doesn't result in healing because they need to feel it. They need to heal it and they need that energy. They need that energy of their emotional fear to go through their healing. And somehow it feels like you've been taking on other people's emotion, this fear of being alone from other people. Yeah. Can you say what were you trying to do? Like, what was your purpose of doing that?
Carrying them in a blanket.
Well, for what purpose? What were you trying to? What were you trying to create?
Fly and feel safe and fly.
Yeah, you're trying to make them feel safe. Did it ever work?
That's it. I've heard it so many times. You're my angel. Without you, without like that. So it got like convoluted. Like you know.
Yeah. Michelle, in the long run, when they get away from you, then that fear, my guess is that it just comes up, it comes back straight away.
Yeah.
You know, they would need to be around you all the time, and that's a form of dependency.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's exhausting for you. And it doesn't really heal them. Like it doesn't give them a chance.
Yes, thank you.
But it makes sense. It was reasonable why you wanted to do it. Because it worked. That people would feel safe when they were around you because you would take on that fear. And they wouldn't have to carry it anymore. and they could finally breathe, you know, they could finally
Yeah.
But in the long run, it actually doesn't work.
Yeah, it could be better than that.
Can you say it again?
I want them to be responsible for them, and feel for them. And
Michelle, you have the tools. You have the tools to hold space for them to go through that by themselves.
Yes, I guess I do.
Maybe,
I have this habit of, it's an unconscious habit of doing that. And I like the vessel, because I am a vessel for that collective. And it's not bad, it's a vessel. It's a different stance around it. Do you see?
It's a different, but it's different from taking on people's emotion.
Right, exactly, yes.
It's different. How is the flow of energy? You say it's an unconscious flow of energy. How does it work?
Yeah, I connect to their pain. I have so many examples. I connect to their pain.
You have it's a technology.
Yes, I connect to their pain. Really, I feel it, I have it in my body. Yesterday I had a call and I even got lightheaded because her thing is so big.
Yeah.
And I'm alone, you know?
Yeah.
And then if I'm in a call like this, it doesn't happen. I'm like, do you see? Mm-hmm.
There's a way also, Michelle, that I have a really strong bubble, and that I don't want other people to have my emotions.
Yes.
So
yes.
I also have this boundary for myself.
Yes, 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 thank you. And when I hold space like this here, or you know, or Zoom like you're doing for me.
Yes.
I do it too. Like it's so,
So you mean it happens with people when you meet them physically?
Yeah, like when it's not a session, let's say, a healing work.
Yeah, okay.
All the time, but still, right? And I've learned to do this when it's more of a healing session.
So great. Then you already have this experience of having a strong bubble and having that boundary. My emotions are mine and yours are yours. And we work with that. You already have that experience of the boundary.
I do.
And and now it's about having that experience continuously to carry that experience. Even when you go walk down the street, because you do it with the people you don't even talk to. I think even with the people you cross down the street, you dock onto their pain, you say their fear, you dock onto that, and it transfers straight into you.
Yes.
It transfers, yeah. And then it's no wonder that you live with this, you know, 30% ongoing fear all the time. It's no wonder. The thing is, Michelle, it will feel very weird for you in the beginning to not do that with the people you love, with your daughters, with your family, with the people you work with, you know, the people at the seminar that you just meet and talk. The habit, as you say, is you dock on and that transfers the fear straight to you.
Yeah.
And now if you're going to keep your boundary, you can probably have a sense of it. What do you think you're going to feel?
Yeah, no, I'll stay with me. I'll stay grounded with me.
Michelle, if when you're going to start changing this habit, and if you stop docking onto them and their fear, what it might feel like something.
Yeah.
Do you get what I mean? What would be your sensation if you don't do your habit?
Yeah. It might feel not on a motor. It might feel grounded and centered.
And there would be it something might... else.
Yeah. I know what that feels like.
Michelle, I'm suspicious that it might feel like you're abandoning them. It might feel like you're
Yes, like abandoning them.
Yeah.
Abandoning.
Because you're not docking on and taking on the pain. You might have this like sense, this freak out of, God, what should I do? What should I do? Because I'm not helping them right now. And it will feel like that in the beginning.
Yes.
This freak out.
Yes, 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 yes. That's so true.
Okay, it's a change of energy orientation. You know, it doesn't mean you can't make a being-to-being connection.
Yes.
But the boundary of these are my emotions and these are your emotion and I'm not taking on your emotions... In the beginning will feel like almost you're not connected because there's a part of you that's been used to connection through this taking on that particular fear.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Yes, it's going to feel uncomfortable and it's going to be great. It empowers them and I keep my own emotions. And I don't think I don't deplete myself.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, much better for them too. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You've made some old decision when you were a baby. In this room, I'm going to tell them to you. I'm alone. I am alone. She doesn't care. It is not safe to be myself, and therefore, I decide to be happy and make other people happy. And this technology of docking on and taking on other people's fear fits completely into that. You know, then they can be happy. They don't have to feel the fear.
Yeah.
I took on other people's fear to make them feel safe so they can be happy. Are those old decisions still influencing your life, Michelle?
Can you say that again, please?
Yes. Are those decisions still influencing your life, these old decisions?
Yes.
Would you like to make new decisions?
Say that again, please.
Yes. Would you like to make new decisions?
Yes. Yes. I want to make new decisions.
What would they be? Don't go into your head. It's in your whole system. You have a different sense. You know, you've learned so much, Michelle, since you were a baby. You really... learn so much, there's already a part of you that is living there, but you still have those old decisions in you.
Yes. Everyone.
Michelle, everyone. I want to give you a hint. For new decisions, it's not about everyone, it's about you.
Me. I. Not everyone. I'm not responsible for everyone.
I'm not responsible. I am responsible for me, like that.
Yes.
I am responsible for me.
Yes.
I'm responsible for me. Yes. I am. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not alone ever.
Often the decisions that are like, you know, I'm alone, then I'm not alone, making new decision like that, it doesn't work because our system is much more complex than,
yeah,
than that.
Yeah. I am a healer and I am responsible for me.
Michelle, my sense is this decision that you made about I am alone and that you would be carrying still today, it's like this place of a victim that you can't connect. But have found so many ways to be in intimacy and be in relationship and be connected.
I am a being, a connected being.
Yeah. I would even say I'm a connector. You know, you are a connector. You're a village weaver.
I am a village weaver. Yes. Oh, yes. I am. I am a village weaver. I am a village weaver. Yes, I am.
A connector.
I'm a connector.
And that means you have developed so many, you know, talents and skills and wish to be in contact and to create relationship and to create intimacy. And so you never have to find yourself in this victim place of I am alone, because you can pick up the phone. You can, even without picking up the phone, make this being to being connection, you know, with me or with Naomi or with Vera or, you know, many people around the world. You can just make this being to being connection and feel this love that is shared.
Yes.
Yeah.
Actually, don't feel alone. I mean, now.
Yeah.
Programming was there.
Yeah, I think the old decision was still there.
Absolutely. Yes. I am a village weaver. I love a lot. Mm. And I feel a lot.
Yeah.
And that's okay. I don't dim my light for anyone.
Can you say that one again?
I don't. I shine bright.
Yeah.
I shine bright. I had said I don't dim my light anymore. And I'd rather say I shine bright. Yes.
Yes. What about this, I take on other people's fear to make them feel safe.
Okay. I trust other beings to evolve at their pace. I am a holder for other beings.
Yeah.
To facilitate their own unfolding, the distinction between space holder and taking on.
Yeah. I'm a space holder for the healing of other people's fear.
Yes.
And
yes.
Much more of it.
Yes. Yes.
And that includes having this boundary. The space holder needs the boundary between your your feeling and their feeling, their emotion, your emotion. And that yes. It's actually in this space between this empty space where there's no enmeshment. It's in this empty space with no enmeshment that the healing can happen.
Yes, in that gap, the healing can happen.
Yeah.
Yes, I am a space holder for other people. No, I am a space holder for healing to happen.
Yeah.
I am a space holder for healing to happen, and I am sourced out of archetypal love. And I am a space holder for healing to happen.
Yeah.
I am sourced
out of. And you never ever have to take on other people's fear. It's over, because you have so many other tools to provide healing and to provide evolution.
I have so many what?
Other tools, like other tools and distinction. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, I have so many other distinctions and experiments and tools and fearlessness, actually, in so many ways. Yeah, I don't need to take on anybody else's fear. I have many other tools and distinctions.
Yeah.
I use my evolutionary tools in magical ways for healing to happen.
Yeah.
And evolution and transformation to happen. I use my evolutionary tools in magical ways for transformation to happen. Like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I wrote it down.
Thank you.
I want to give you a distinction. Probably you've heard it before, but just also from your lineage is the indigenous way, an old way of shamanism was exactly what you were doing. You take on other people's, you work it out through you, and then you are the healer in that sense that you take on what other people cannot handle and you work with it. And then in a way that creates, as we say, this dependency, and the person has to come back again and again for you to do the work. And yes. And what we're talking about is next culture shamanism, where you are a space holder for people to take care of their healing. And you don't have to involve your personal space or take on their fear or take on their other emotion for that healing. You can be this space holder for them to go through it. The client, you know, the client goes through the process. Yes. And that's next culture shamanism.
Next culture shaman. I am a next culture shaman.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you for that distinction. That makes sense also, because of the collective vessel that you share, that distinction it's empowering for me to look at it like that. And not, I tend to not share it anymore because it happens a lot.
Hmm.
Collective pain or fear, anger, sadness, it happens a lot.
Yeah, I think sometimes you will have to feel it when it comes like that into that vessel.
Yeah.
You know, when it needs to be channeled, it needs to be felt by someone. And that's very different. The collective field is very different from an individual personal fear that you would take on.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, and I've had fear about sharing it because,
because
I just have had fear about sharing that, and it happens a lot.
Misha, I'm thinking, do you know Dagmar Tunagel and Mikael Hanninger?
You've met them. I know Mikael. The feelings. I did the feelings lab.
The feelings practitioner, yeah. And they have been really working and researching about this collective, experiencing the collective pain, like trauma or emotions. And they would be really great people for you to talk to and get, you know, I don't know what they got in their latest research.
Oh, great. But I did a channeling Light Bee session for Micaela, so she's aware because she knows me.
Yeah.
That's.
Yeah.
I love Micaela. I know her well. And Katarina was there too. So, yes. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Michelle, for going there.
Thank you, Anne-Chloé. Thank you.
And so I just want to say, it will feel weird in this beginning, this boundary. And you will feel this, like, maybe this pull, this need of saying, of docking on. And just to really pay attention to this, this move, like this energetic move. And to say, and to stop it, and to say, I'm holding my boundary and I'm holding space. And just, it will be a sensation. It will be a sensation, and that's how you can catch yourself when you might do it unconsciously. And you'd be like, okay, this is over. That was the old way. Now I'm a space holder.
Okay.
Do you already have a sense of that, of the sensation that happens?
Yeah, I do. It's because it happened right after my experiment. 2 days later, it's like a tingling down my spine, and a pressure, kind of pressure here on my solar plexus.
Okay.
Those are like the two sensations that I feel.
Yeah. And this, there was probably going to be this, you know, this fear that we talked about, this sensation of, God, I'm abandoning them. I'm not helping them. And just let the fear circulate. Just let the fear circulate and keep the boundary. And that will be your detector.
And keep the boundary with a bubble and all that.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then I think this fear and even the sensation, it will just get rust, like it will just fade away as you stop using it. You know, in a couple months, it will just go away because it's, you're not using it anymore.
Yeah, good. Okay, so it'll take a few months.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, habits die hard.
Yes, yeah, it's fine. If it's a few months, I'm happy about that.
Yeah.
I've had this for so many years.
Yeah. I'll take a picture of the notes and I'll send them to you, with especially the old decision and the new decision. And if there's anything you can't read, just point it out and I'll type it in.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much for this, Anne-Chloé. And thank you to everyone who sees this and learns and is healing others so that transformation can happen.
Yeah. Thank you, Michelle, for your service and big heart. Yeah. I'll see you soon.
I love you.
Me too. Bye.
Bye.